Welcome back to Sportsbook Review Videos. We split a pair of NBA picks on Tuesday evening. I am back once again to release my two best NBA picks for a very large and very intriguing slate of NBA. Lots of players that could be rested here tonight. Also, of course, we have Kobe Bryant's last game and the Warriors going for history in 73 wins. But with that being said, I have a couple of plays I think could hold some value this evening, and we'll start it off in Brooklyn, where the Toronto Raptors are coming into town as a 4.5-point road favorite in this one, total of 205 to 205 and a hook. Now, no word on whether or not the Raptors will rest their starters in this one. It's probably likely that they will. Would be seriously probably a bad move by Dwayne Casey if any of his main players saw the floor here in this one. However, that could play into our hands tonight on the first half total, which has not come out just yet as of time here for this video, but estimating with the total here at around 205.5, first half total should be around 203, 204, maybe, or 103 or 104, something like that. I think the over could once again be a really good play. We cashed the over in the first half total for the Raptors yesterday. That's just going to mean that they're tired coming into this one. Brooklyn has not been bad scoring the basketball here recently either, and neither has the Raptors. But one main thing that the Nets have been doing over the last five games is giving up points. They've given up almost 60 points per first half in their last five games. Raptors, on the other hand, very good against their own division. Of course, it's not a great division, but scoring about 53 points per first half against their division this season, and giving up close to 50 both on the road and against their division here all and overall this season. So if we can bank on the Nets getting to 50 points in the first half in this one, potentially the Raptors resting their starters, maybe playing a little faster and a lot less defense, especially on the second half of back-to-back, I think over in the first half is a very good play here in this one. Both times these two teams have played, they've got at least gotten to 100 at the first half. I think they get to a little bit higher than that. Take the over here. We'll double check that those odds once they come out. Now, finally, of course, Kobe Bryant's last game in Los Angeles and overall here this evening against the Utah Jazz. And if it was against any other team other than the Utah Jazz, who are still trying to get into the playoffs, they need a win tonight and a Rockets loss to the Kings. I don't think the Rockets are going to lose tonight, but I think the Jazz are going to do everything in their power to get the win here tonight. And surprisingly, the odds have already dropped down all the way from 8 to 5.5, and I know the theories about Kobe Bryant's last game. He's going to be amped up. The Lakers crowd is going to be on fire tonight. Of course, probably the other Lakers are going to be very hard-pressed to try to get Kobe a win, go out in style. However, the Jazz are just too good, and even though they will be without Rudy Gobert here in this one, they still have plenty of talent and enough to get the job done, especially with them playing hard as they will be tonight in order to get the win. I think 5.5 is a pretty good bargain considering they've beaten up on the Lakers three times already this season. The two first meetings against one, so that they were already without Gobert while he was injured. So I don't think much has changed here in this one. Of course, they dominated them by like 50 points about a month ago when the whole D'Angelo Russell thing broke as well. So Jazz have been pretty good here too. Won and covered their last three games in a row on the road. I love the renewed energy of the Staples Center tonight with Kobe Bryant's last game. That's going to help the Lakers. I don't think it's going to be enough to cover the spread, though, here. I'm laying the points with the Jazz at 5.5. Best of luck to you on those two. Make sure you check out my player prop picks as well coming out later today. But until then, for Sportsbook Review, I'm Jordan Sharp.